Welcome back to Nature League, a member of the Complexly family of videos. It's the second week of the month, which means it's time for a field trip. Now, when you think about a field trip for biodiversity theme month, you might think about, you know, going to the rainforest or a coral reef. But the thing is, you can actually find biodiversity even in the most human-built environments. So we're right here in downtown Missoula where we are gonna check out some pieces of biodiversity. Now, during our lesson plan, we talked about a couple different ways that we can think about biodiversity, and one of them was use. So actually using things, provisioning services like food or shelter or medicine. And medicine is actually a really cool piece of biodiversity in terms of how humans use it. Right now, we are here in downtown Missoula, and we've actually come inside a compounding pharmacy. Compounding pharmacies are really cool because they're kind of like that old school feel. So think about actually really using that chemistry and making something specific to the dosage or the mixture that you need. And that's what they do here. So that means they have more raw materials than perhaps somewhere else, like a mainstream drugstore. So when you're inside a pharmacy, there's actually biodiversity everywhere. And we can actually just start right here. These are a bunch of essential oils, and you may have heard of essential oils. You might even have some in your house, might be something your mom uses, whatever it is. If you look closer, you'll actually see that essential oils can be seen on the species level. Each one is from a different species of plant, and they actually have it labeled with the genus and species right here. So just on this countertop, we're looking at close to 20 different species, which is super awesome and probably not the way you usually think about something like essential oils. So right up here, you can see something that you might be more used to thinking about at the grocery store, but there's actually things that come from different fruits that are in all kinds of medicines that we use. So right here, we have some cranberry extract. Now, what about something that's not a plant? What about an animal, for example? How about fish? So if we check this out, a lot of different supplements for fatty acids and omega-3s come from fish species that you can see right here. And let's think even smaller. What about bacteria? Check this out. In probiotics, you actually have a ton of different species depending on the brand and what kind of ingredients have been added. But if you look on the back here, you can actually see there are several species of bacteria just in this single pill of a probiotic. So look, you've got a fruit, you've got a fish, you've got bacteria all sitting here on one shelf. Even your run-of-the-mill aspirin pill is actually derived from a plant species, which is the white willow tree. So even if the plant species is not actually being used in the main form, sometimes they're used as additives. So for example, when a cream has aloe added into it, that's coming from a species. Or something like vapor rub, that awesome minty kind of thing that you have, well, that's actually from two different species. You got eucalyptus and also menthol, which are both derived from species. And now a word. Not from our sponsors, but from the dictionary. Welcome to this month's Wild Word. Once a month on Nature League, we'll look at the etymology, or origin and history, of words related to nature. This month's theme is biodiversity, so we're going to examine a word that's used throughout the material in this topic. The word is organism. This is a pretty common word, and we certainly use its pieces, organ and ism, in many different English words. But let's dig in deeper and check out these parts. The ending, ism, is a common one. Ism can be traced back to both Latin and Greek as isma and ismos, respectively. This ending was added to words to signify a practice or teaching of something. So what is the word organism hinting at practicing? Let's look at the first piece of the word, which is organ. This one is interesting because over the course of history, the word organ started being used in two different ways. The word organum in Latin translates to instrument, like a mechanical device, but also translates to organ, like the musical organ pipe. But the plot thickens. There's also a verb in Latin, organizo, which means to organize. The word organism most likely comes from a combination of the noun form, meaning instrument, and the verb form, meaning organize. So while the former Merriam-Webster definition of organism is a complex structure of interdependent and subordinate elements whose relations and properties are largely determined by their function in the whole, organism literally means the practice of organizing or being a device. I love the connotation of this word. It means that when people long ago were considering life on Earth and calling all the forms they encountered organisms, these people were recognizing that the life forms not only had a purpose, but were highly organized. And this was all before we even knew about the molecular structure of things. And that is pretty awesome. So being in the pharmacy reminded me of some really cool examples I've learned along the way in terms of studying biodiversity and how it's used in pharmaceuticals. So for example, I remembered that the pit viper, so a snake, is actually where we got ACE inhibitors, which is for blood pressure, which is a major, major thing that we use. Also AZT, which is a compound that's used for treating HIV and AIDS complications, which you know, used to be a major deal, but with the advent of AZT, it's lessened the symptoms for people living with that disease. And that was actually derived from a marine sponge. So people living with this debilitating disease are actually being helped by an organism they've never even met that's deep in the sea somewhere, which is really, really cool when you think about it. But biodiversity is way more than just how we use it. It has value in all kinds of ways. So for example, it's not just provisioning services like I'm eating it or I'm using it for medicine. It's also regulating services, things we might not even think about. So like, let's take this tree right here. As I speak, it's actually taking carbon dioxide out of the atmosphere and in return, putting oxygen back, something that we don't really think about when we're just walking around and see trees downtown. And then there's my favorite value of biodiversity, which is intrinsic value. All of the species of life on Earth, big and small, all have value just because they exist, which is something I think is pretty awesome. Thanks for coming with us on this field trip for biodiversity right here in downtown Missoula. We also want to say thank you to the Montana Compounding Pharmacy for letting us use their space and show you their products. Also, thank you to you for joining, and definitely tune in next week where we are going to break down another piece of scientific literature on denatured. We'll see you then.